everybody, it's Lynn from WisconsinGarden.com, and today we're having a very exciting visit here at the Redeemer United Church of Christ. This is our fifth visit here, and it has a unique landscaping idea because it's a prairie. They decided instead of going traditional landscaping, they wanted to do a prairie, and over the years, I think it's been about 10 years, they have created a beautiful, living, growing, evolving prairie. And we've taken it now through the four seasons to show how it looks at each part of the year. And you can see, being spring now, the old plants are done. The birds have eaten what they've needed over the winter, and things have grown and now fallen down. And so every other year they choose one part of the prairie and they burn it. They call it the burn, and that gets rid of all of the scrub that's left over, and it also helps the new seeds that are in the ground and seeds that they're going to be adding to get a chance of actually growing in a fresh area. So this is something that is very, very controlled. They have a special person that comes in, totally equipped to handle any possibilities that might occur, and they're very particular about what the weather's like.
Well, we're going to be meeting with Rick and Nancy Volbrook shortly, along with the fire team who's going to be out here doing this control burn. So, right. But it's interesting. We thought it'd be interesting to take a look at it before.
Yes. And they have to be very careful about the weather, and because it has not been a very wet season, there is a concern because things are really dry. They have picked a beautiful day. There's very little wind, and it's sunny for us. That's nice. But this will look so much different when the burn is done.
Well, they'll be spreading seeds immediately after the burn, and then kind of raking up the soil, loosening up the soil a little bit, at least the top, because I know as you go down, it's still frozen.
Yes, it is. But you can see that, you know, these are flowers from last year. They have been picked clean of all the seeds that would have been in there. And that's, you know, part of the cycle of nature. Some have fallen down, a lot have been eaten. So in order to get down again to the basis and near the soil, they're going to burn this off. And they pick a different section every other year and clean that out.
Now, I know it's getting harder and harder to get permits to do burns.
Yes.
You know, many, especially in dry areas or when the weather is dry, you probably can't even get a burn permit anymore.
Right.
But
they're
know.
Very specific now, who's doing it, what is their business, you know, where are you starting, are you using anything to start?
Accelerants.
Rick was saying it's just really difficult now, instead of just going in and say, oh yeah, we're going to have a bonfire or whatever, you just sign a name and say when. It's very, very technical now. Well, I'd like to introduce Rick and Nancy Volbrook. They're the ones that are responsible for the beauty of this prairie and maintaining it, and it's wonderful to be able to come and visit it. Also, this has been your fourth burn now, because you've done around the fourth burn. What have you noticed after the burn? I mean, the burn itself is exciting, but what happens after the burn and now you've got all this charred landscape?
Well, and it is charred. It looks pretty nasty. It's like, whoa, what happened here? And sometimes some of people, from when they come to church on Sunday morning, if they didn't know we were doing this, they'll drive in and say, oh my gosh, what happened? Green comes up very fast, and in maybe 3 weeks or so.
Oh, or maybe less than that. It's amazing.
Yeah, it looks like you didn't even know there was a fire.
I mean, things start coming up, but you can't see them because there is all the old stuff.
Right.
And you only do one area at a time, right?
Right. We've got about 4 acres of prairie here, and every other year we burn about half of it. And part of the reason for that, from our understanding, is that you don't want to burn the whole prairie at one time. because there's a lot of things growing out there you don't see. And that's
well,
insects.
And there's insects, right.
Right,
insects. And they need some place to move to when the plant life is not there.
So if you burn the whole prairie, you have a good chance of destroying a lot of the native critters that are around here. But burning half of it, that gives the other half still a chance to survive and thrive and then repopulate the area that's been burned.
Interesting.
Now, what are some of the conditions that you have to do to even before burn takes place? What kind of things do you have to, who do you have to contact?
Well,
permits?
First of all, we like to do it in spring, and it has to be done before things start greening up. So this is the ideal time. And we are required to get a burn permit from the town in which we're located. They have control over that, whether we're allowed to do a burn or not, based on weather conditions. We hire a professional company who's done this for us in the past, so they're totally experienced with it, and they're very cautious, and they'll, on a day of the burn, they'll look at what the wind is like, feel what direction it's coming from. If it's too windy, it's a no-go, and we would just call that off because it's just not safe. But then once it starts, there's fire breaks around the area that get burned so that if fire does start getting out of hand, it hasn't anywhere to go. And they will burn into the wind so that they'll start burning an area at the far downwind area and burn cautiously into the wind so that if the fire should start flaring up, that it would then come into an area where there's no fuel because it's all been burned already.
That makes sense.
Yeah.
Now, does it cost you anything? Now we know the how and what's going to happen. Why do you do it in the first place?
The first thing that comes to my mind is that we burn the prairie to stimulate plant growth and seeds. Seeds are stimulated by fire.
Now, are you thinking the seeds are in the ground?
Yes.
Okay.
And so that's one main reason. Another reason is that it does get rid of all the dead plant material, and people like, it looks nicer that way.
They don't like this look?
No, they're not real thrilled.
And a lot of the tall stuff that's standing 4 and 5 feet tall now will go down.
Yes.
But, you know, in reality, if you didn't burn, in the years that we don't burn, when spring comes and stuff starts growing, the new growth, the old growth will topple over as the new stuff pushes up, and by May, you won't see any of the old stuff standing anymore. If we do, we knock them down and help them along. But the new stuff is taking care of it, and it'll start looking
just
beautiful.
Decompose
right.
By itself.
Yep.
Another thing we're going to do this year after the burn is we saved, I don't know, lots of seeds. In fact, I think we may have been collecting some of them in our last video.
Mm-hmm.
They were in our basement over the winter, and we spent one day taking all the seeds off of all these and keeping them all separate in these bags, and they're in the refrigerator in the basement. And now when the burn's done, we're going to come and scatter all these seeds all over and wait.
Yes.
And maybe they won't come up this year. Maybe they'll come up next year. Maybe they'll come up in 2 years when we burn again.
Interesting.
Seeds come up when the conditions are right, and you never know where they're. So we just keep scattering seeds, and you do it long enough, and eventually you'll have more flowers.
One of the things that's happened, and we were told this would happen, the natural progression of a prairie, that certain flowers that were there at the beginning kind of give way to other flowers that come along.
Mm-hmm.
And what we've noticed happen, especially in this section of the prairie, is that there's a lot of yellows. Now, we know that's probably about 10 to 15 different varieties of yellows, but to people that
yellow.
Aren't knowledgeable on it, it's all yellow.
Right.
And they'd like some other colors in there.
Mm-hmm.
So some of the plants that we will be putting in, the seeds that we'll be putting in, will introduce some other native prairie plants with some additional variety and color, something else we can talk about except yellow flowers.
Right.
White. My big theme this year was to go with white. So we had a lot of, if you remember back in the corner where the garden is, there's a lot of quinine back there. That is a white flower. And once you get it growing, you can't stop it. So that's the kind of thing that we would like to have here. So we have a lot of quinine seeds. It's always exciting. You never know. You just it's an act of faith. You put them down there, and then you just wait and see what happens.
And we have seen over the years too, plants that were not there suddenly they're growing.
And you haven't.
We don't know where they came from.
Put them in just.
We haven't put them in. They could have been carried by birds or wind from another part of the prairie or somebody's yard or whatever.
But,
you know, there's just always a kind of a revelation when you find something. It's like, whoa, look at this. Where'd this come from?
That's the fun of it.
It is fun.
It's just evolving, you know, before your eyes.
Do you remember last year we found a butterfly weed plant way in the front by the road? We did not plant it there.
No.
I have no idea. And the only other place we have butterfly weed is back in the garden. So I don't know. But there it was.
There it was. The beautiful
orange flower.
Yep.
So that's fun.
Well, we'll have to bring some liatra seeds too.
Yes.
Yeah.
Get your liatra.
Then you have some purple.
Yeah. You can never have too much purple.
And the last year we had a lot of coneflowers.
Yes.
Purple coneflowers.
Yes.
That, before there were just small pockets of them, and last year they seemed to be in abundance. So it's just fun every year to see what new is going to happen.
Sure.
Some of our favorites start fading out, and other stuff comes up and surprises us. We're happy for that.
Well, good. Well, once they get started, it was really amazing. That footage is just exciting, but at the same time, so easily could it get out of control if the right person who's been trained to do this isn't in charge. And that was what was so amazing about watching these fellows do their job, because they knew what they were doing. The wind had picked up a little bit, but settled back down again while they got to work. And we can't say enough about how wonderful it was. Unfortunately, because of time schedules, I wasn't able to be there to actually watch the burn, but Rick obviously was, and he was impressed.
I'm still sunburned. I think I have 30 degree fire burn.
I see. Well, it did. At first it was very calm out, and then it did get a little windy. But you said when you got home, your face felt like it was
burned. It still feels. My eyeballs feel dried out.
Well, and I hate to tell you, you have odor to yourself, too.
Oh, thank you.
I'm going to have to wash your jacket. For sure.
Suppose you want my pants and my socks and everything else, right?
Possibly.
Uh-huh.
Now that you've seen the burn, this has been our fifth video that we did at the prairie, and we've gone through all four seasons now, and we were waiting for this burn because, like we said, they only do it every other year on different parts of the prairie. We'd like to thank Rick and Nancy Volbrick for including us in their prairie, and for Jason and his crew, and what an amazing job they did. The Redeemer United Church of Christ has been very open to having us do these videos and being able to share them with their congregation. We appreciate that very much. If you've enjoyed this video, please give us a thumbs up. We'd love to hear your comments, and if you've witnessed something like this, please share what you've done too. And if you'd like to become part of our garden family, please subscribe. The little button's right over here. Bye for now.
So do I have to get undressed now?
Yes, I need your clothes.
Outside?
No.
Okay.
Connect with us on YouTube.